Hi, I'm Gretel, Customer Success for Comet. In this video, I will show you how to set up the Comet Backup Client on a Synology NAS for Synology's native SDK packages, as well as how to set up a backup and restore. Let's get started. Comet has a Synology installer, which we can download from the Comet server web interface. We will cover these steps in the video. The web interface offers two downloads for Synology, one for DSM-6 and one for DSM-7. The Comet installer is available for Synology NAS, which meet these CPU requirements. The Synology installer does not include a graphical client. Instead, creating protected items and running backups and restores can be done from your Comet server. We will cover these steps in this video as well. An additional fee applies when backing up a Synology NAS device. Head on over to our pricing page linked below for details. Here are the steps to download and install the Comet client for Synology NAS. On DSM-7, Comet runs a special package-specific user named Backup Tool. In order to perform backups and restores, this user must be granted permissions to access the appropriate shared folders. We will cover these steps in the video later. To download the installer, go to your Comet server. The Comet server is your main interface for managing all of your devices, backups, and users. In the Comet server, click on Download Software. Here, you can download the Comet client installer for Windows, Linux, macOS, and Synology. Download the Synology installer for your DSM version. Next, let us install Comet in the Synology NAS. In your Synology NAS, go to Package Center. Accept the terms and agreement here, and click on OK. Click Manual Install in the top right. Then upload the Comet installer and click on Next. On a DSM-7, a window asking you to accept the installation of a third-party package will pop up. Click on Agree. Accept the license agreement and click on Next. Log in with the user credentials, then click on Next. Since I am installing Comet on a DSM-7, I will have to grant this user permissions to access the appropriate shared folders later. For now, tick on the box and click on Next. Click on Done to finish the installation. Comet is now installed on the Synology device. On DSM-7, Comet runs a special package-specific user named Backup Tool, and we need to grant this user permissions to access the appropriate shared folders. We will cover these steps next. In the NAS, launch the control panel and go to Shared Folders. Select the shared folder containing the data to be backed up and click on Edit. Go to the Permissions tab. Select System Internal User from the drop-down menu on the left. Click on the box under Custom for the User Backup Tool. In the Permission Editor window, make sure that Apply To is set to all. Under Permission, make sure that all the boxes under Administration, Read, and Write are ticked. Click on Done and click on Save in the following windows. Now that we have installed the Comet client on our Synology NAS, we can configure and run backups from the Comet server. As we mentioned earlier, there is no Comet client interface on the NAS, so all actions must be configured from the Comet server. In the Comet server, click on Users and look for the user the Synology device is logged into. Go to the Devices tab and you will see the Synology NAS. Here, you will be able to run manual backups from the device, restore backups from this device, and push remote upgrades. To start setting up a backup, go to the Protected Items tab. Click on Add Protected Item. Choose the device you want to backup. Choose the backup type here. For this demo, we will set up a file and folder backup. Click on Next when done. Here, you can choose the files and folders to protect. Click on the green folder here. Select the items to backup. Remember that if you are backing up a DSM 7 NAS, you would only be able to back up folders that you have permission to access. If you add folders that you do not have permission to access, your backup will still work, but will return a warning telling you that some items were not backed up. After selecting the files and folders to protect, click on Save, then click on Next to move on. Here, you can configure command lines to run before and after a backup. You can set up backup schedules here. Click on the plus sign to start. You can set up several backup schedules. Choose the storage vault where you would like to store each backup schedule. You can direct backups to different storage locations, either to on-prem or to cloud storage. Next, click on the time tab. Here, you can configure the actual frequency of your backups. Click on the plus sign. Choose the schedule type here. You can set up backups as frequently as on an hourly basis. Choose your backup frequency here and fill in the details. After you have completed the setup, click on Save. Click on Save again here. Click on Next and click on Save to complete the setup. We have now set up a file and folder backup that will run weekly. Let us run a manual backup so we can also show the restore process later. In the Protected Items tab, click on Run Backup. Make sure you are pointing to the storage vault where you would like this backup to be stored and click on Backup. That was successful. We now have a backup that we can restore. Here are the steps to restore backups of your Synology NAS. In the Comet server, go to the Devices tab. You can restore backups to another device as long as it is also registered to the same user. In this case, we will restore files to this device. Click on Actions and click on Restore. Make sure this is set to the storage vault where the backups are stored and click on Next. Click on the device that we are restoring from and choose the protected item to restore. If you have run more than one backup, all the snapshots will show when you click on Show All. Click on the version you want to restore and click on Next. You can either choose to restore all items or select specific items to restore. Click on Next after making your selection. Choose the location to restore files to and click on Restore. Once the restore finishes, you will find the files in the new device. You can also restore files back to the Synology NAS to recover lost files. In the Devices tab, click on Actions for the Synology device that we are backing up from. Follow the prompts same as the earlier restore process. Select the items to restore. Here, you can indicate a specific location to restore to in the NAS. You also have the option here to restore to the original file location. Click on Restore when done. And that is the end of this video. We showed the steps to download the Comet Synology installer, as well as how to install it in the NAS. We also configured and ran a backup and showed how to restore a backup. Please check out the links below to our process guides. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.